Good morning, student. Today we have to cover design of quarter joint. So this is the model of a quarter joint. This green portion is called as a spigot. This white portion is called as a socket, and this brown portion is called as a quarter. These are the views of the parts of the quarter joint. This is a socket, and this is the quarter. This is socket, this is the spigot, this is the quarter. The slot is provided in the socket, as well as slot is provided in the spigot to insert the quarter. This is the section of the quarter joint. This green portion is your spigot, this brown portion is socket, and this red portion is called as a quarter. This is the sectional view of a quarter joint, and the various notations are shown in this views. D is the diameter of the rod. D2 is the outside diameter of the spigot, and D1 is the outside diameter of the socket, and various other dimensions. T is the thickness of the quarter, and L is the length of the quarter. The various notation are written in this on this slide. D is the tensile force, D is the diameter of each rod, D1 is the outside diameter of the socket, D2 is the diameter of spigot, D3 is the diameter of spigot collar, D4 is the diameter of socket collar, A is the distance from the end of the slot to end of the spigot on the rod, B is the mean width of the quarter, C is the axial distance from the slot to end of the socket collar, T is the thickness of the quarter, T1 is the thickness of the spigot collar, L is the length of quarter, sigma T is the permissible tensile stress for the rod material, tau is the permissible shear stress for quarter material. Now we have to see the various failure that can be occur in the spigot end. So in spigot end, there may be three types of failure: tensile failure, shear failure, and crushing stress. Now we have to avoid this failure by keeping the proper dimensions of the spigot end. So see here, this is the spigot end, and the tensile failure is may be occur at this slot, because at this slot there is a weakest area of the spigot. So this is the tensile failure of the spigot end. Then another type of failure that may be occur in this spigot end is shear failure. So due to the quarter, the spigot end is subjected to shear stress, that is a double shear. So double shear may be occur in the spigot end. And the third type of failure is crushing stress. So see here, at this, due to quarter, there is a load on the spigot end, and due to that there may be chances of the crushing stress. Crushing stress is the stress induced at the contact of the two component. Here two component is your spigot end and the quarter. So there may be chances of crushing stresses. So now we have to see the stresses in the socket end. So socket end is also subjected to tensile stress, shear stress, and crushing stress. So this is the socket end, and this is the resisting area for tensile failure. This is the resisting area for tensile failure. And another type of failure in the socket end is shear a failure. That is a double shear. So this is the resisting area of the socket end. And third type of failure may be occur in the socket end is crushing failure. So crushing area is the area, this is the your crushing area. In 3D diagram, it is this area of crushing. Now stresses in quarter, because they have there are three portions of the quarter. One portion of the quarter is in socket end, middle portion of the quarter is in spigot end, and bottom portion of the quarter is in socket end. And the forces acting on the quarter are equal and opposite. Due to that, double shear of the quarter may take place. So we have to avoid this shear failure of the quarter. So this is the problem statement. We have to design the quarter joint according to this. It is required to design a quarter joint to connect two steel rods of equal diameter. Each rod is subjected to an axial tensile force of 50 kilonewton. Design the joint and specify its dimension. So this is the problem statement. According to this, we have to design the joint. Step to be followed. So these are the five steps we have to follow. First is selection of material. Second step is selection of factor of safety. Third step is calculation of permissible stresses. And fourth step is calculation of dimension. And fifth step is dimensional sketch of the quarter joint. So selection of material, first step. As we know that the quarter joint is subjected to tensile or compressive stress. So generally mild steel or plain carbon steel is used as a material for quarter joint. Second step is selection of factor of safety. The factor of safety selected for the quarter joint is in between 1.5 to 2. In this, the factor of safety for quarter is taken as a less as compared to factor of safety for the rod as well as spigot. Third step is calculation of permissible stresses. Permissible stresses are calculated by the formula sigma t is equal to SYT upon FOS. Sigma c is equal to SYT upon FOS. And calculation of dimensions. So there is a step-by-step procedure for calculation of various dimensions. And we see in next step. Then dimensional sketch of the quarter joint. At the end of the design, we have to draw the three views of the quarter joint. So this is the step number one. That is for this is step number 4.1, diameter of the rod. When the axial force is applied on the quarter joint, the rod is subjected to tensile failure. So our general formula for tensile failure is sigma t is equal to P by A, where P is the load and A is the resisting area. So in case of rod, our resisting area is pi by 4 d square. So putting the value of A as a pi by 4 d square, putting the value of sigma t, permissible tensile stress, and P as a load to be applied, we can find the diameter of the rod. Step number 4.2, thickness of the quarter. Generally, the thickness of quarter is taken as 0.3 of the diameter of the rod. This is the empirical formula used to find the thickness of the quarter. Then step 4.3, diameter of the spigot, means outer diameter of the spigot. So see here, this is the cross-sectional view of the spigot. This is the outer diameter D2, and this is the thickness of this slot. So spigot end is also subjected to tensile failure. So again, our general formula for tensile failure is P by A, where A is the resisting area. So by this case, we can find the resisting area. A is equal to pi by 4 D2 square minus D2 into T. So in previous step, we have calculated T. So putting the value of T, P and sigma T, we can find the diameter D2. Now, step number 4.4, outside diameter of the socket. The socket is also subjected to tensile failure. So again, sigma T is equal to P by A. And according to this sketch, D2 is the inner diameter of the socket and D1 is the outer diameter of the socket and T is the thickness of the slot. So by putting the value of D2, T and P and sigma T, we can find D1, outer diameter of the socket end. Now, in step number 4.5, we have to find diameter of the socket collar D3 and socket collar D4. So for this, we use empirical formula. Diameter of the spigot collar D3 is 1.5D and diameter of socket collar D4 is 2.4D. And next step is dimensions A and C. Dimension A and C can be found by following empirical formula. A 0.275D and C is equal to 0.75D. After finding the dimensions by empirical formula, we have to check that dimensions. So we check that dimension in next steps. This is the step number 4.7. In this step, we have to calculate width of the quarter, that is mean width, because quarter is having a taper of 1 in 32. So we have to calculate the width of quarter at the center or at mean position. So the quarter is subjected to double shear. So see here, this is the sketch of the quarter. The quarter is subjected to double shear. And the shear area is B into T at one side. So at two side, it is 2 into B into T. So we have general formula for direct shear stress P by A. So putting the value of A is equal to 2 in bracket B into T, we can find width of the quarter. Now we have to check for the crushing and shear stress induced in this spigot end. So here, the crushing stresses induced in the spigot is given by sigma CR is equal to P by A, where A is equal to T into D2. During the operation, the spigot end is subjected to double shear. The direct shear stress induced in the spigot end is given by tau is equal to P by A. So, using these two formulas, sigma CR and tau, we can find the shear stress and crushing stress induced in the spigot end. Similarly, we can find the crushing and shear stress induced in the socket end. Sigma CR is equal to P by A, where A is equal to T D4 minus D2. And similarly, we can find direct shear stress induced in the socket end, tau is equal to P by A. Now we have to calculate we have to find the induced stresses in the spigot collar. So the formula for spigot collar, empirical formula for spigot collar is T1 is equal to 0.45D. So due to axial compressive force, the spigot collar is subjected to direct shear stress. The direct shear stress induced in the spigot is given by tau is equal to P by A, where A is equal to pi D2 into T1, where T1 is the thickness of the spigot collar and D2 is the outer diameter of the spigot. After finding the various dimensions of the cotter as well as spigot and socket, in final step we have to draw the three views of the cotter joint. So this is the sectional front view of the cotter joint, this is the top view of the cotter joint, and this is the side view of the cotter joint. So in this way, we have designed the cotter joint. Thank you.